Do you know how much, though? I mean, do you have a price tag for all of this?
We do. I mean, you know, and the price tag is, it will be substantially less than letting the current system go. I think it's about $30 trillion.
That's just for Medicare for all.
Just Medicare for all.
Do you have a price tag for all of these things?
No, I don't. You mentioned making public colleges and universities tuition-free and canceling all student debt. That's correct. That's what I want to do. We pay for that through a modest tax on Wall Street speculation.
But you say you don't know what the total price is, but you know how it's going to be paid for. How do you know it's going to be paid for if you don't know how much the price is?
Well, I can't rattle off to you every nickel and every dime, but we have accounted for it. You talked about Medicare for all. We have options out there that will pay for it.
1 year ago this week, Medicare for All was introduced as a way to replace most private health insurance with a national single-payer system. Joining us now is the chief sponsor of the bill, member of the House Judiciary Committee, and health policy chair for Senator Bernie Sanders' presidential campaign, Democratic Congresswoman Pramila Jayapal of Washington. Great to have you on board this morning, The Washington Post. Bob Costa has the first question for you. Bob?
Congresswoman, good morning.
Good morning.
In Senator Sanders' interview with CBS, he talks about a modest tax on Wall Street speculation as a way to pay for Medicare for all. Who specifically would be taxed in that scenario?
Well, if you did it on Wall Street speculation, then obviously the people who invest in the stock market and make enormous amounts of money off the stock market would be paying that tiny financial transactions tax on their financial transactions. And I think the thing here to think about is that we have a healthcare system that literally causes people to die. We have a healthcare system where people are paying 10 times more for insulin in the United States than they do in Canada. We have a healthcare system where 500,000 people every year file for medically related bankruptcy because of medically related costs. So this is untenable. The system as a whole will cost us $55 trillion over the next 10 years. So the question here becomes, why would you protect the status quo? And how do we make sure that every single person has universal care? In the last year since I've introduced the bill, we have had a historic 4 hearings in the House of Representatives. We have over half of the Democratic caucus, including top leadership. We have 30 unions that have sponsored the bill, an incredible racial justice coalition, because people understand that we have to imagine a different kind of guaranteed government-provided insurance program that will allow everyone to get health care. No copays, private insurance premiums, or deductibles.
If Senator Sanders is elected president, would Democrats like yourself accept an incremental application in pursuit of Medicare for all, perhaps just going after, to your insulin point, the negotiation of pharmaceutical drug prices rather than just demanding this whole program wholesale?
No, here's the problem, Bob. If you try to keep the private insurance companies in the marketplace, what you do is drive up costs. The whole problem with our healthcare system today is that it has started to put profits over patients. We have a system where 30% of our entire healthcare costs in this country are actually going to administration. And that is really ways to keep people from getting health care and provide big CEOs with huge paychecks. But it's not providing people with health care. So we have to fix that underlying problem, or you do not bring down costs and you do not provide universal care for everyone.